Thanks, Chad. Now, you guys are on horseback, and I am in a side-by-side with a group of ATVs. Now, Robert Frost talked about the road less traveled, you know, when a road diverges in a wood. Well, today, we're going to take both paths.
The paths diverge on Highway 89, about 15 miles east of Kanab, Utah. My group heads north through Johnson Canyon, unloading our ATVs at a sandy parking lot, while Chad and Rhea's group continues east toward the horse trails. While our roads will be different, our ending point will be the same.
Well, we're on top of Seaman's Point right now. We've taken a beautiful ride all day up this area, both by horseback and by ATV, and I think both parties had a fantastic time. Discovered some wonderful area.
My riding group is made up of members of the Utah-Arizona ATV Club, Kanab residents, as well as Dirk Clayson, one of the Kane County Commissioners. Our road is going to be a rugged and eye-opening one.
We left Nephi Pasture Trailhead, and we went into Long Canyon. Long Canyon is a canyon that runs east and west.
It's kind of a sandy road with a lot of scenic areas that we passed through, and we were able to look at several scenic sites.
Some petroglyphs and also some pictographs, and they're together in one alcove down there. It's quite unusual to see them both together there because they are two generations actually. The pictoglyph came first and then the petroglyph.
This area is rich in Native American history, with evidence of their lives scattered throughout the canyons and dry washes. A surprising amount of green meets the eye as the trails lead through BLM land and some private property. Club members are always conscientious to stop and make sure private fences are closed behind them. The ride itself wanders purposefully through a world of color, tranquility, and beauty. Near the planned end of our ride at Seaman's Point, we stop and hike to a site that even few locals know about, a hidden arch that dominates the view of the horizon.
Inchworm Arch is two arches together, a small arch and then a larger arch that is connected, and it actually looks like an inchworm that's going across the sand.
For club president Tony Wright, today is about more than just arches and riding. His young grandson has come down for the weekend and is enjoying his first real ATV trip into the wild. While Tony has visited many of these areas dozens of times, everything about today seems new.
Well, it helped me see it through his eyes. You know, every time we go around a corner or something there, he says, wow, that's great, Grandpa. And I let him drive a little, so that was a new experience for him. And it was just a great day to be out. You know, show him the outdoors, show him the things that I love out here. And it was great to be with him. It gives him a whole different perspective on life itself.
Families bonding, riders exploring, memories being made. It's a day on the trail that makes it all possible, a day in the outdoors with the people we care about. And the trails around Kanab are the perfect canvas to paint memories of family togetherness.
We've just got thousands and thousands of acres that all have scenic, iconic things on them, and so if you talk to some locals, you can find out some good places to go. Kanab is really welcoming to the tourism industry. We just have a really friendly community.
Two roads were taken today. Ours was by ATV, and what we were able to see in that time was amazing. The beauty, the history, the relationship strengthened. Some choose a motorized path, others a non-motorized one. But when the sun is on your back, the wind in your face, and adventure at your beck and call, what really matters is that you have the people you care about by your side. After all, it doesn't matter the wonderful things you see and experience unless you have someone with whom you can share them.
Every turn is something new, it seems, because we have a chance of seeing, maybe going down a little different trail, seeing something new. I really enjoy coming with the old timers that know the area and can point out something that I might have missed before, like a petroglyph or the dinosaur footprints or something that is just spectacular.
Well, it's great to get out of the office or out of your place of work and just get out and smell the fresh air and look at the scenic landscape. It really helps relieve the stress in your life and give you a fresh perspective.